days got Brasil.
Niggas is trying to eat. That's all I look at it as. Niggas want to eat food. Yo.
Time is money, motherfucker, and money matters.
E o que? É só good placa na tarada. É só good placa na tarada. E o GM só dá goleada. É só good placa na tarada.
Olha o gol, olha o gol, olha o gol, olha o gol, olha o gol.
GM, explana ela, caralho. Vai!
We'll be right back.
freak a leak, peep, peep. Let a nigga sneak a few peekaboo. Let's see what.
Finish her. Fatality. Brutality. Flawless victory. Test your might. Test your luck.
Moments later. 1 eternity later. 3 days later. 12 seconds later. 3:28 a.m. 3 weeks later. Many months later.
So much later that the old narrator got tired of waiting and they had to hire a new one.
Tomorrow. Tomorrow for sure. Eventually. 12 o'clock midnight. 2 hours later. Meanwhile. 8:01 p.m. The next day. Later. 20 minutes later. 6 hours later. Several.
Cidade de Deus.
É, sim. É grande, né?
É grande. Dá a volta.
Brasil. This is a quick little recap of my trip and what this channel's about. Okay. Angra Dos Reis. I found out about this city maybe 2 years ago with my ex. She put me on to this place. Then I went back with the person I'm talking to currently. And for the second time, I gave it a 10 plus. I like it. Now, this is a place you go to with your girl or somebody you've been talking to for a while. You don't just hop on Tinder or Brazil Cupid and some random chick you just met as soon as you touch down to Brazil to Rio. You take her there. You don't want to do that shit. You want to take somebody you feel comfortable with and somebody you know. You take them here. And this is a place where basically two type of travelers travel here. The first is rich Brazilians, seasonal for vacation. And the second traveler would be like somebody like myself, who's been to Brazil, been to Rio de Janeiro many times, and have many people that they know that they can take there. The place you're seeing is through booking.com. I don't use Airbnb. I never had a bad experience, but I heard people talk about their bad experiences. So I'm like, fuck all that. You know, why jump through all the hoops of, you know, submitting a photo and have to copy my passport and do all this shit just to rent a place when I could just continue what I've been doing for years since the early 2000s, which is through booking.com. So that's what I like to use. This place was $120 a night. I know you're probably thinking, well, goddamn, that's a lot of fucking money. Well, when I travel the world, any place, it's not about how much it costs. It's about two things: being comfortable and having not good but great location. And this place had both. Now, what was included in the $120 was, of course, your free amenities of, you know, free Wi-Fi, free breakfast, air condition, but just the extra little things, like it had a small private beach, private pool, private pier and bar. I don't drink, but my girl, she drank, so she liked that. Of course, you know, your free Wi-Fi. But the most important thing, you know, besides the location, because, you know, that's what I like. Every morning you wake up, you have, boom, the ocean view. Atlantic Ocean is right there in front of you. So you can't beat that deal. Well, in my eyes, you can't beat that. Now, this place is like I said, 2 hours and some change away from the Copa area west, going towards west. And you might think, well, shit, is it safe going there? And the answer to your question is no. Meaning that, you know, you're not going to go there and just somebody's going to like smash you over the head and take your money. I'm not talking about that kind of being unsafe. But what I'm saying is anywhere you at in Brazil is unsafe. Like somebody told me, the whole country is dangerous. And that's Brazil for you. That's how it is. You know, Brazil is one of the most dangerous countries in South America. You know, and number two would be Venezuela. Number two is not Brazil, because Brazil is the biggest country in South America. So that's why they're number one, because they have the most population. And you have to be on your P's and Q's when you in any place, no matter where you at in Brazil. Sao Paulo, Manaus, Fortaleza, São Luís, Belém. It don't matter where you go. It's unsafe. So you have to expect the unexpected. And, you know, the picture you're seeing flashing is of a woman. Her and her family found out about Angra Dos Reis. And they went there. And I guess they never had seen a favela before. Because what they did was they pulled in the favela, not knowing it was a favela. And they got shot and fucked up. Had to go to the hospital. So that's just an example for you how dangerous Brazil is. You know, you always got to be on your P's and Q's. Now, with this family, my thing is, when I go to any country, if it's not in the U.S. of A, I'm not driving. You know, I don't want to take a chance renting a car and doing what they did, which was going into the wrong neighborhood, driving to the wrong location, and get fucked up. So now I got to recover from injury, and now I got to probably pay for the fucking car that got fucked up, and all kind of little things, miscellaneous things that happened during that time that I could just said, you know what, let me just lay back, take a taxi or Uber, and go to all the places I want to go, and be safe. So just a pointer for newbies. And even for the people that's been there, they probably know this. You got to stay safe at all times, you know. And you might think, well, okay. Well, you know, at nighttime, I'm going to, you know, maneuver this way. No, no, no. It's Brazil. So anything can happen, daytime or night. Okay, what's my channel about? Airplane mode. Well, my videos are going to be about travel, not just to Brazil, but the world. Food, because I like eating and cooking. Fitness, because that's what I'm into, health and fitness. And also women. I'm a single man. Now you're probably wondering, well, you have a lot of different videos with different women. Like, what's going on? I've been traveling to Brazil since 2008. I've been traveling the world since 2003. And I can make another video about how I was put on to traveling. And I'm non-military. But I've been traveling to Brazil since 2008. So it's 2019 now. So that's 11 years of going back and forth to Brazil. So that's how I accumulated over all this time, knowing different people, women. Okay, so how do you meet all these different women? Well, I'm doing what everybody else is doing. It's 2019. Everybody's utilizing apps. So one of the apps I do use is Tinder. And, you know, of course, you got your Brazil Cupid. And you got your good old, once you touch down in that country, you know, on foot, whatever you see, you holler at. Because you might not see her again. And you're on vacation. So why not? So those are the things that I do to meet women. I also got to do another video on how Brazil was in 2008, my first visit to Brazil, how that was. Because usually, whatever country you go to, your first time is your best time. It's the most unforgettable. And that's true. That's a fact. That's not opinion. That's a fact. Wherever you go to in the world, your first time is usually your best time, unless some unpredictable shit happened to you that make it your worst time. But after, like I said, I got to do a video about that. My first time to Brazil, 2008. And how was it? Because when I went back then, it was a famous for all, not the non, not the newbies, but for the vets who's been in Brazil since that time, 2008 or 2009, before it closed, Club Help. I have to do a video about that. It's kind of, it's going to be funny. It's going to be entertaining. Now, the young lady in the video, I met her off Tinder, like I said, like over a year ago. So I've been knowing her for a long time. Very cool. Decided to take her on this a little vacay. She loved it. And I know now that she'll probably never forget that trip. And she'll probably never forget me because I was the first person to take her there. She has kids and she has a job. She's not a garota de programa. No, she's not. Not to knock anybody that mess with prostitutes, because that's what that word is, prostitute in Portuguese. I'm not knocking anybody that does that on their travels, but with my travel channel, I'm not against it, but I just don't do that. Not to say that I haven't messed with a woman that was her job, because that would be a lie. I have. But the key thing is, I did not pay. And something to keep in mind, not all women that sell themselves want to deal with a man, seriously, who's going to offer them money or pay for their services. So to break it down in layman terms, for something that you might pay for, the next man might get for free. Plain and simple. You know, that's just how life is, you know. She's going to treat you much different than she might treat me because of different reasons. You know, you might be too short. You might be too skinny. You might stink. You know, you might be too dark. You might be too light. Whatever her reason is, she might not want to fuck with you unless you put something in her purse. You dig what I'm saying? So all that, you know, well, everybody paid. Like, that's another thing. Like, I don't want, that's stupid shit. That's not true either. Like I said before, what you might pay for, the next man might get for free. It all depends. Because you best to believe, whoever you're paying for in what country you go to, it's got to be some dude in that country, he ain't paying for that shit. That's a fact. Brazilian comida. What do I think of Brazilian food? Brazilian food can be healthy, but the majority of food in Brazil is not healthy, as you can see. Different types of meat, different types of sausages, not a lot of vegetables. It's just kind of unhealthy, to be honest with you. But when I'm in Brazil, I try to get the healthier choices. Or, majority of the time, I cook my own shit. So, I go to the grocery store, buy a lot of fruits, buy a lot of vegetables, buy some meats like you lean, you know, chicken, some fish, and I cook my own shit. The only time I eat out is with my girl, and we don't eat out every day. So it'll be like a Friday thing, you know, something like that, a weekend thing. But every day eating out, I don't do that shit in Brazil. Like I said, when I'm there, I buy my own meals, cook the shit myself, and that way I kind of save a little money. But the most important thing is I want to get healthy foods inside me. You know, I want to eat healthy. So the next time you're in Rio de Janeiro, get you an Uber or get you a good taxi and get a set rate and take your girl to this place. You enjoy it. And you can just thank me later. My next video is going to be a new destination, but still in South America. And then after that, I want to go back to the subject of my first trip, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, 2008, and what made me decide to go in 2008. Because around that time, it was not a lot of people going there, and also it was not a lot of videos on YouTube. So a lot of people want to know, well, how did you find out about it and what made you go? So that's going to be the video after my next destination.